Welcome to the Christ Clarity Channel, where we gain familiarity with the big picture. And as events play out in this world, as they most certainly will play out, it will be easier for you to say, yeah, okay, this is just a mad dance of existence, playing the way that it must play. But I am not troubled by this too much, because I realize I have the option to choose another idea. I'm not bound to eternally be part of this crazy dance that's taking place here. And I tell you that, like many people take a walk around the block every day, they may walk, take their dog out for a walk or something like that. If you spend the time like that with these videos, it's like taking a walk around the block with these videos. Every day, you will be in a vastly better place. Because of that, you will become fit. You will gain fitness. You will gain spiritual fitness, spiritual clarity. And when times come, that will come into play. When situations begin to change drastically, that will play a role for you, a very positive one. So get in shape. Have a routine. Pay attention to the big picture. It's very valuable for you. Most neglect to get in true spiritual shape. They'll get in shape physically, a lot of ways, nutritionally, etc. But they'll neglect getting clear about the big picture. They'll neglect that. And unfortunately, that will play a role for them too, because at some point, it becomes necessary to be familiar with the big picture in order to avoid the designs and constructs that some have to foster your destiny in existence. You will be told that this is what you're supposed to do, this is where you have to go, what you have to do, what you have to submit to. These are the blueprints and designs that are presented to you. But you will know very well, if you truly have spiritual fitness and are clear about the big picture, that this is all nonsense, because what you really have as spirit is the full capacity and authority and capability right this moment and every moment to choose a new idea and literally therefore set the effects of existence gently down as you pick up the effects of this new idea, which will be wonderful effects. It will be the effect of seamlessness. This is the great peace beyond understanding that has been spoken about. This is the great bliss, not just bliss, but the great bliss. The seamless garment seems to cover everything, all experiencing, all effects as they dance in the halls of existence. This seamless carpeting, this seamless garment of absolute tranquility and undisturbed peace will cover everything without exception. That is a fact, but that this effect comes from a different idea, choosing a new idea. It never comes from the effect of trying to replace reality with a new reality, which is what existence is. Existence is the effects of that idea arising and playing. It never comes from that. Only comes from choosing a new idea. That's the only way you can do it. But this new idea of not trying to replace reality with a new reality, this new idea that spirit chooses, sets the previous idea down very, very gently, lovingly and compassionately, because it doesn't try to get rid of it at all. Because it's not trying to get rid of anything. See, it's the idea of not trying to get rid of anything. And as such, all the effects in the dance remains, except it's covered. It's like covered with a gentle snow. Everything's carpeted with this pristine, clear, beautiful, gentle feeling of perfect tranquility and peace, unending peace. And no matter what happens, you could have an atomic war and it wouldn't touch the fabric of this garment in the slightest bit. You see, and you will experience that, even though you can still be here and everything is, all the effects and dynamics are dancing around you. The mad swirl of existence is still there, and yet it has no effect on this profound peace at all. Doesn't even touch it in the slightest bit. That's a fact, and that is something that you have access to as spirit by choosing a new idea. The idea of not trying to replace anything, not trying to replace reality at all. Not even trying to replace the attempt to replace reality, you see. It's a beautiful, wonderful idea. You will allow the dance of existence to still arise. You still perceive it. You can still see it. You're aware of it. And yet the feeling that you have now is not as undisturbed by it. That's what we have access to. That's the goal. We're not trying to build some utopia. Utopia is right here and now with the choosing the idea of not trying to replace anything. That's instant utopia. For anyone at any moment can have that. Nothing in the world has to change at all for this utopia, for you to have this portable paradise with you. The entire world could be engaged in a massive conflict, swirling all about you. And the feeling of peace that you have will not be touched in the slightest bit by any of that. That's a fact. You have the portable paradise at your fingertips. All spirit has to do is choose this idea of not trying to replace anything, not trying to get rid of anything. And the peace then that arises from that, nothing will get rid of it, because that's the intent, not to get rid of it. The effect is then will be that which cannot be gotten rid of, because there's no motive or desire to get rid of it. You see how that works? We are trying to attain this in the wrong way. We're trying to go about loving everybody, thinking, okay, I love you, I'm not trying to get rid of you, I love this. That's piece by piece by piece by piece. That you can never arrive at it that way. It comes automatically and effortlessly from choosing a new idea, the idea of not trying to replace reality with a new reality. That automatically, from the very beginning, covers everything that could possibly ever arise in this perfect feeling of peacefulness. It's completely effortless. That's what our aim and purpose is, as we see the big picture of existence, big picture of reality, how we are truly able to function and choose new ideas, and how effective this particular idea is in setting down the previous idea very, very gently, because we're so identified with this idea, so fixated, so much believing that we are bodies in a world, and this world is our home. We've been believing this for so long and investing so much devotion and fixation on it. We want to set it down very gently and carefully. We don't want anything to happen to it. It's our baby. So, of course, this idea enables us to let down, to set down, to be perfectly gentle and compassionate and loving. That's why this idea is so effective. I mean, theoretically, we could choose a completely different idea and existence would vanish for us instantly. The universe, whole universe would vanish. But most of us don't really want to do that. We have too much devotion to what we've been working on for so long that we really don't want to see it just vanish like that. We want to set it down gently and lovingly. So this idea of not trying to replace anything enables us to do exactly that. Everything remains. All the dance of existence remains. And yet it doesn't disturb our peacefulness in the slightest bit. And after we experience that for a while, then we'll be very happy to move on to other ideas. That's how it works. That's the really big picture. And we may say, yeah, it cannot possibly be that simple. No, 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 no. But I tell you, it is existence that's claiming it can't be simple. Existence wants it to be as complex as possible. Existence wants its replacement to be as difficult as possible. So of course it's going to say, oh yes, you can transcend existence, but it's really, really difficult. And you have to spend lifetime after lifetime, you know, standing on your head chanting somewhere. Very, very difficult. Or you have to learn to love every last single person, every last single thing, every event. You have to learn to somehow be accepting and loving of that one by one. All of this, and it's going to take you so long to do all this. You will be told that. That is all delaying tactic, trying to delay the inevitable. Existence does not want any notion of how simple it is to slip into the mainstream dynamic here, the marketplace of ideas. Okay, it wants it to be as difficult and time-consuming as possible. Yet the fact is, it is absolutely simple. At your fingertips, every single moment of existence will always be right there to choose a new idea. You can do it at any moment. It's that simple. The real battle of existence and of your awakening is between simplicity and complexity. The struggle is to realize how simple it is, and the defense of existence is to try and instill the belief that it's very difficult. Okay, that's the battle. That's the battle line. And so every time you listen to simplicity, you are winning that battle. And every time you turn away towards complexity, you're losing the battle. So it ebbs and flows that way. The more you can see how simple it is, how truly it is, you don't need to carpet the world, you just put on a pair of sneakers. It's that simple. The more you realize this, the closer you get to actually employing that simplicity and choosing a new idea. And we're all trying to get there as fast as we can. We don't want to delay any longer, because delay is never a good idea in existence. Existence is a very changeful place. Sometimes the change is dramatic and swift, and then it seems like we're engulfed by complexity and difficulty, and we don't want that. We want to realize the simplicity of it as fast as possible. We've been in a very stable phase now on this planet for quite some time. That's coming to an end. And things will seem very problematic and difficult and complex very soon. So we need to get the big picture and realize how simple the solution to existence really is before the storm hits, the storm of complexity and difficulty hits. That is why the 20th century was a time of great teachers and great teachings, so that these teachings could disseminate and get into the system here, and people could begin picking up on them. Unfortunately, I was one of those who picked up on these teachings, and have had fabulous, great teachers, and incredible teaching, and great preparation during the 20th century, and then carried that through into the first decade of the 21st century. So it was tremendous preparation to realize the simplicity of it all. All this took place over the last century or so, because there was foreknowledge of the complexity and difficulty and rapid change that is soon to take place. I'm saying it'll take place in 2011, beginning last part of 2011, and then into 2012. And that will be a time of very rapid, drastic change. So it's very important to continue to focus on simplicity, the simple truth, That's the rumble of change in the distance you hear. It's very close. Focus on the fact that you can choose a new idea. You will always have that capability. Nothing can take it away from you. Every single moment you have that capability. It's omnipresent, always present, eternally present for you. Every place, every time, every situation you will ever find yourself in existence, in time and space, you will always have that sovereign capability and authority and capacity to choose a new idea. Nothing can ever take that away from you. No situation can ever take that away from you, even in the tiniest bit, no matter where you find yourself. That is a fact. That's an absolute fact that's incorruptible, unchangeable, eternal fact for you. It's your guarantee of happiness and satisfaction. It's right there. And don't let yourself think that just because things are fine wherever you are right now, that everything's going to remain fairly stable. It's not the case. So it's so very important, even though you may be in a good, tranquil situation, to continue to press forward towards simplicity of understanding and realizing that the remedy is incredibly simple. And reminding yourself of that all the time. It's a very simple remedy. No matter what teaching you're employing, remind yourself that it's not complex, it's not complicated, doesn't require any formulas. I don't need to memorize anything. I just need to remember that I can choose a new idea. and I can choose one that's perfectly suited to setting down the one I had previously very gently. I can do that. I don't have to do anything first in order to do that. I don't need to acquire some type of spiritual status in order to do that. I inherently already am that, which has the full capacity and authority to do that. I already am that, have always been that, will always be that. There's nothing I need to do first to be that. I am that. It's that simple. All right. Much clarity to you, always. That's it.